What is up, guys? Tava here, and today I'm going to be showing you 5 cinematic techniques to creating this awesome jib-like shot with just a camera and a tripod that looks super cinematic and professional, but is super easy and almost completely free. So if you just look at this technique and someone doing it, it looks a little bit complicated, but when you actually get into it and start doing it yourself, it's actually incredibly easy and fun to do. So this is how you do it. Basically, the main idea for the technique is to keep your camera level while your tripod moves forward and back, so you can get a shot that has dynamic movement, but is still level and stable. So to do this technique, my first advice would be to lower the 2 legs in front of the tripod. So extend those first 2 legs and keep the back one lowered so you can move off the front 2 and have room to work because you have that back one lowered so you can move forward and back without having it hinder your shots. So with the legs lowered and your tripod head loose, you're basically ready to go and do this technique. And like I said, it's super easy. All you do is just push in and try and keep the camera as level as possible. But because that's easier said than done, here are 5 cinematic techniques to make it look better. My first piece of advice would be to use the grid on the camera. So basically just go into your settings, find the grid so you can have grid lines across your screen so you can very easily tell when the shot is level or not. What I personally like to do is line up one of the grid lines with something in the shot. So you basically have a steady line throughout your shot, and basically what you can do is as you move in, just keep that line exactly level with the thing you had it level with at the beginning. And that helps to create the really level and steady jib-like shots that move really steady without much up and down motion or side to side motion. My second tip is starting your camera at an angle, and this starts to get a little more artsy and challenging, but basically what you want to do is push your camera all the way in and then rotate it on the tripod so it's at a bit of an angle, and as you pull back you rotate the camera and pull back simultaneously, and this just creates a super cool dynamic shot that I think is really creative and hard to get other ways, especially handheld or even on a professional jib. My third tip is to start with a pan up or pan down. So basically when you're moving your shot backwards, you want to pan up or pan down at the very beginning. And this is just a really cool way to introduce the shot or subject that you want to be panning into. So basically you're going to be bringing the camera down towards the subject and reveal it as you're pulling back. And like it sounds, you can really only do this in one direction. So if you're making the jib shot pull back, you can pan from up to down before you pull back. And if you're pushing forward, you can go from down to up as you push forward. It doesn't really work the other direction, but it is a cool shot to introduce more motion and creativity. And then my fourth tip is kind of a no-brainer, but it's just the idea that subtle shots are sometimes better than more dynamic and creative ones. So as you can see in some of these shots, the camera does move forward, but it's very slowly and there's not a lot of motion around it. This still adds a lot of interest to the shots, but it's not quite as flashy, which can be good in certain situations. And then finally at number 5 is the idea of adding focus pulls into your shot. Now this is significantly easier to do with cinema lenses like I was using in those intro shots, but you can do it with any lens. So with the focus pull, as you're moving in or out, you want to match the focus to the subject you started with. So as you pull out, you focus away from the subject to always keep that one in focus. And this technique just really helps to keep the audience's eye set on a single point on the screen, which is really good at directing attention. Anyway, those are my 5 cinematic tips for mastering the DIY tripod jib. If you like this video, be sure to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you all next time.